Hello, everyone. Hey there. I'm going to wait probably about 5:03 now, probably about another minute for people to come on. But if you guys want to introduce yourselves in the chat box and say who you are, where you're from, that would be awesome. I'm letting more people in. Very cool. Who do we have on here? I talked to Gina. Gina's on. Lindsay's on. Awesome. Stephanie from South Texas. Wonderful. Tamara from Kentucky. Mary Snell is on. Wonderful. Rob Wolf, Karen, Long Island, New York. Awesome. Another New Yorker on here, Northern Michigan, North Carolina, Michelle, Pennsylvania. Awesome. I'm letting a couple more people in. Saudi Arabia, Canada. Wonderful. Just want to say hi. I'm Larissa Maloney. I'm the owner of Active Kids 2.0. I will get started here, probably about 30 seconds as I'm letting a couple more people in. Arizona, Charlotte, North Carolina, Lamont, south of Boston, Lindsay from Philadelphia, Michelle from New York. You're welcome. Thanks for coming, Michelle. Wonderful, wonderful. All right. So it's 5:05. I'm going to get started. I know it is Friday, and I know we're looking forward to a nice, relaxing weekend. If you're anything like me, it's been absolute mayhem for the past couple weeks if you've started school. It's been a little crazy. But I want to just introduce myself. I'm Larissa Maloney, the owner of Active Kids 2.0. I kind of want to let you guys know how I got started in Active Kids, a little bit about me, and I also have a coach on here that's one of my Active Kid coaches. Her name is Janelle. She is my dance coach, and she'll be speaking in a little bit after we get started. So I'm going to go ahead and put the website here. If you guys, the way it's going to go on here, if you guys want to say anything, ask any questions, please do through the chat. I'll be addressing them as they come. There's always a lot of questions that you guys have, and I am absolutely going to answer it whenever you guys put it in the chat. And then that's Janelle up there for my dance coach. So again, I'm Larissa Maloney. I'm the owner of Active Kids 2.0. A little bit about me. Whenever I see New York, I'm saying, hey, New York. I was born in Buffalo, New York. I moved down to Florida when I was about 5 or 6, but I still consider myself a Buffalonian because I'm from New York. I've played sports all growing up. I was a 3-sport athlete in high school, volleyball, basketball, I ran track. I ended up going to a school in South Florida, Boca Raton, called Lynn University to play volleyball on a volleyball scholarship. And then I ended up playing on the professional beach volleyball tour for 5 years. So I got to do something I loved. And I know a lot of us on here come from a sporting background, and literally PE teachers are former athletes. They're my favorite kind of people. Very competitive, very fun, and like to learn and have a passion for learning as well as enjoying what they do and are good at their craft. So that's a little bit about me. I also teach at a private school right down the street from me. I'm in Daytona Beach, Florida now. I'm on the East Coast, and it's a small private school. We have about 400 kids. And I know back, and it feels like years ago because we've been doing so much, but I know we were all in the same situation. I keep letting people in, but we were all in the same situation back in March where I literally got, we had an emergency teacher meeting on a Friday, right? And the principal said, you know, just to let you guys know, we might be going virtual, but we're probably not. But if we are, I just want to give you kind of a heads up, because we might be going virtual, right? I'm pretty sure everybody had that meeting. Literally that night, I got an email a couple hours later saying, we're virtual, figure it out. So I know we all went through that, and it was crazy. And we kind of all had to figure it out, and we all had to figure it out together. I came home after reading that email, I literally sat at my kitchen table and I said, what am I going to do? PE virtually, like, what does this look like? I want to do something fun, but I don't know how it's going to work. So I literally sat down and I wrote down on Mondays, we're going to run a mile. They're going to give me a time. Tuesdays, we're going to do arms and abs. Wednesdays, we're going to do something different. Thursdays, Friday, something different. I wrote it all out, and then I looked at it after, and I threw it away. Like, literally crumbled it up and threw it away because it was horrible. Because my kids know me. I am in the class. I am engaged. I do things very, very structured in my classes. I'm not a fitness instructor that just throws out balls and says, go play. And that's fine if you are, but I'm just not. And I'm very structured, and I want my kids to, you know, learn while we're doing things, and I want them to stay engaged. So I thought to myself, what's the best thing to do to keep them engaged and to keep them, you know, keep the feeling like they're there with me. So I have a little home gym in my garage, and I said, you know what? The Monday, I'm just going to turn on, you know, press record, and I'm going to put it on YouTube, and the kids are just going to do the workout with me. So, and we'll figure it out from there, right? So I have about, like I said, I work at a smaller school. So I have about 75 kids that I see throughout the day for personal fitness. And so Monday morning hit. I said, I'm going to do these workouts Monday through Friday at 9 a.m. every day. Monday hit. Okay. I start my warm up. I press record. I'm live on YouTube. And, you know, a couple of people come in. It's probably about 15 people. I'm like, all right, my kids, you guys better start logging on, right? I got 75 kids and 15 of you are on, right? So after my warm up, you know, I go to the computer just to check to see how many people are on. And then all of a sudden it was 50 people. Then it was 100 people. Then it was 200 people. Then it was 300 people. Then it was 500 people. Then all of a sudden it just grew. I literally had a phone call a day before from a friend, and she does like a health class at a neighboring school. And she asked what I was going to do. And I said, I'm going to just go live on YouTube. She said, can my kids do it with you? And I said, yes. And it just spread like wildfire. And I literally, in that day, hit over 5,000 people watching, or 5,000 kids and their families watching the workout for the day. So I literally did that for the 3 months of our quarantine. I did it every day, Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. the same time, and I ended up reaching over 50,000 families just within our 3 months. I did Mondays, I did like a little sports circuit where I did different sports exercises within the 30 minutes. Wednesdays, I had my little five-year-old with me, and he might be coming up here, because, you know, it's 5 o'clock on a Friday. But I had my five-year-old with me, and he did a workout with me too. Thursdays and Fridays, cardio and strength classes. Really, you know, fun. And we had you know, optional weights too. Most of it was no equipment, but I did do on Fridays the optional weights. So within that 3 months, I reached over 50,000 families. After that 3 months, we went into the summer, everything sort of calmed down, but then I was getting messages from families and all of that, and they were asking, are you still going to do these videos? You know, it's kind of become a tradition in our house, and, you know, not only is the student doing it, but the whole family has gotten into it, and I know at that time, it was, you know, very low when, you know, everybody's spirits were very low. So they really came together. The community came together over these videos, and they had, you know, grandma, grandpa, mom and dad doing these videos, you know, with them, and it created a community. And I got messages from different schools, and I was shouting out different schools and different students and teachers, and it really, really became a community. And that's really what the PE community is all about. From there, that summer, since getting those messages of this is a need, we need this, I decided there's something bigger here. So that is when Active Kids 2.0, the platform, the fitness and wellness platform, really, really came to be, and it evolved. So now Active Kids 2.0 is not only me doing my cardio and strength classes, it is now dance. We have yoga, we have karate, we have boxing, strength, cardio, toddler time, jazz, ballet, hip hop, all of that, really, really right now is Active Kids 2.0. And also I'm introducing a health and nutrition, portion of it as well. So I know we have a lot of health teachers in here, and I know a lot of PE teachers have to include that health factor into it as well. So that's really the beginning of how I created Active Kids 2.0, and it's really taken off. And I know that you teachers are, I mean, us teachers, we have a lot of stress on us, and we're asked to do a lot of things right now that is making life harder in this time. And for me, we need things that are going to make things easier in this time. So let me show you what Active Kids is all about. I have a little there we go. I have a little video. If you guys hear my little one, she is singing in the background. She's 4 and she loves to sing, so don't worry. All right, take a look.
All we see is your agenda right now.
Uh-oh. All you see is my agenda. Hold on 1 second. Let me get that off. Well, let me admit one more. Did you hear the music at least? Let's see.
Heard the music for a little bit.
Did you? Okay.
But then it stopped.
See it. Oh, here it is. All right, I got you guys. Can you see it now?
Yeah.
All right, perfect. So that's a little preview of Active Kids 2.0. So the Active Kid program is 20 to 30 minute classes. Okay. So I know that we're usually not in class any more than that. It includes a warm up and a cool down. All of those specialty classes are included in there. So everything that you saw there and more, there's yoga, boxing, karate, dance, cardio, strength, toddler time, all of that stuff. We have a full on-demand library and it's updated weekly. Also, this complies with all of our social distancing guidelines. This is the most important thing right now, okay? Equipment, like I said before, you don't really need any equipment at all. We do have some strength classes, but everything you can adjust to no equipment as well. It also aligns with the national PE standards. I know that is important as teachers. We also do a couple of things in our PE classes that have worked for us. The floor tape is absolutely huge, especially if you have the younger kids. I mean, let's be real, the older kids need the floor tape too. I have high schoolers and the guys are literally hugging each other every second that they can get. So the floor tape works wonders. Making sure you have, you know, little boxes to separate them and a box for yourself. And sometimes as teachers forget that because we need a box for ourselves because we also need that personal space as well. And I don't know where you guys are at in your protocols for your school. Like at my school right now, I have them wear masks in PE class. We stay inside. Sometimes we go outside. If they're outside, they can take it off. Inside, if they, you know, feel like, you know, they need a second, they step away and they take their mask off. But usually during the whole class, they leave it on. And these classes are okay with them leaving it on as well. We're not allowed to use any water fountains or anything like that for our school. So everybody has their own water bottles. You know, they bring it in from home. It's labeled themselves. And they have to make sure that they bring that every day to class. For our changing sessions, we do it, and this is just to give you a couple of ideas. For our changing sessions, we do it in four at a time. We have a bathroom in the front, and then we have a locker room. So we try to get them in there, in and out of there. And also during the changing part, if I have anybody sitting there idle, I always give them a fitness challenge so they know if they don't get to the bathroom first, they have to do a fitness challenge. So give them something fun to do while they wait. And so, you know, they're not horsing around or playing around. While they actually wait to get changed. Okay, perfect. So if anybody has any questions while I'm talking, again, go ahead and put it in the chat. A lot of teachers, these are a couple of ways that teachers are utilizing this program. I have teachers that are hybrid, I have teachers that are fully virtual, and I have teachers that have their classes and they're fully in school and they're still using this program. When you sign up, you get a unique, or you get your email that you sign up with and you have a unique password, okay? Some of them that are fully virtual, they either give their students that, you know, their email, and then they make a very easy password for the students to get in. There is no limit on the students logging in themselves. So if you have a class of 100 kids and you're asking, can they log in at the same time? The answer is yes. They can log in at the same time, do whatever class that you're asking them to do. Some of my teachers, if they're fully virtual, they share their screen and they have all the kids doing it with them, which is really, really fun as well. That's a fun way to have the kids together, but they're not obviously in the same room. Another way is I've had, you know, teachers that are in school and they have a couple of projectors up and And they're streaming it, okay? So they're streaming it through different projectors through the gym. a couple of things. Some teachers like to give the kids a choice, and they fill out a fitness log for the week. So on a Monday, they could have a choice of, do they want to do a boxing class or karate class or something like that? But all they do is fill out a fitness log to say what class that they did. And all of the students will have access to all of the classes. On the website, I also provide you guys a fitness log, so you don't have to make that up yourself. It has a fitness log and it has reflection questions at the end. So that reassures you that they're actually doing the content, that they're actually doing the videos. What else? Let's see. In my school, the only thing that we use equipment-wise is a yoga mat that is in school. I am also a hybrid model, so while my kids are doing it in school, I have to share my screen, and I have kids on Zoom doing it at home as well. So it works out really well because they're doing the same content and I can actually see that they're doing it. And since I'm doing that hybrid model, they don't have to do a reflection. So if, you know, you just gave them the fitness log and they're doing it on their own time, I would definitely recommend them doing a reflection with it too. If you guys don't have any questions yet, that means I'm doing a good job and I'm explaining it pretty well. The program itself, it's Active Schools, and this gives your whole school access to this program. So if you have multiple PE teachers, each PE teacher can use it under the same login email, okay? If you have maybe like a pre-K, I know a lot of you guys are elementary, if you have a pre-K that wants to do it as well, under that Active Schools membership, everybody gets to do it. So it's a pretty cool system that everybody can benefit from in your school. For the Active Schools membership, it's $200 per month. Janelle, our active dance teacher, has a promo code right now, and it's Janelle10. With that promo code, it is 10% off, and it would be $180 for the month, or for the year, sorry, for the year. I'm going to turn it over to, if you guys have questions, I'll be typing it in the chat and I'll address questions at the end. I'm going to turn it over to our active dance coach, and she's going to show you a little bit of what a dance class would look like.
Hello, everyone. I'm Janelle. I am a dance coach with Active Kids. I've been training in a lot of different styles pretty much all my life, from classical ballet to modern, contemporary, jazz, even tap. I definitely value physical fitness in my life. I love being active in the dance classroom and outside the dance classroom. And I'm a strong believer that an active body creates an active brain as well. So that's very important for students. In my classes, I like to have a concept-based lesson plan. So basically, we focus on a specific skill each class, and also we might focus on an overarching dance concept. So that might be time, space, energy. So those are things that are within all types of movement, even outside of dance. So we start off with warm-up, then go into some technical exercises. Then I like to do choreography, so the kids get to practice the technical skills they're learning and have lots of fun performing wherever they are and cool down. So I'm gonna show you a little bit what I like to do in the technique part. I'm going to show you a jazz technique class, and the concept is size. So small, medium, and big incorporated into the movements. And the skill that we're gonna be working on for this demo right here is kicks, so grand battement. Let me get my music. Okay. Can everyone hear that? Okay, awesome. So I'm going to explain the combination first, and then we'll get right to it. So everyone, let's start with our feet together, toes facing forward. We're going to practice our kicks and learning the concept of size and movement. So what does it mean to dance small, medium, and big? So we're going to start with our tendus. Four tendus, brushing forward, small movements, then go to our dégagés at a medium height. Then we're going to practice our kicks big. So make sure you're kicking really big. I want your arms stretched out to the side. We're going to go batma, ball change, kick, ball change, kick, ball change, then step together and do the other foot. Okay? We're going to do this turned in and turned out, paying attention, working small to big with our movements. All right. Stand ready. I'm going to turn on the music. Ready? Tendu, front, small, dégagé, medium height. Ready for your kick and batma, ball change, kick, ball change, big kick, ball change, kick, and step together, other leg. Tendu, small movement, dégagé, medium height. Bring out your arms. Ready? Let's go. Batma, big kick. Big. Try to touch the ceiling. And go. Good. Let's turn out and practice that again. And tendu, small. Dégagé, medium. Now big kick. Ball change kick. Ball change kick. Try to touch your hands. And again, tendu, small, on the floor, dégagé off the floor, medium, put your arms out, ready, and kick, as big as you can, kick, ball, change, kick, ball, change, and step together, good. Awesome. Thank you guys so much.
That was wonderful. Great job. Great job, Janelle. That was great. All right. So if you guys have any questions, please put them in the chat box. Like I said before, I teach high school. So we do a little combination so they don't get bored and antsy. Like on a Monday, we do boxing. On the Tuesday, we do cardio. On Wednesday, we do yoga. On Thursday, we do strength. And on Fridays, I give them a choice. So they get to pick a class or they get to go outside. Some kids wanted to run the mile today outside. And I said, okay. And they kind of regretted it after they did that. But I said student choice. So Fridays, they get to have a little fun with it. So if you have any questions, please go ahead and put it in the chat box. Can you repeat the 180, what that includes? Yes. So the 180 for the year includes all of the on-demand classes. So you get access to all of those classes that I named. Unlimited for all of your kids. And it's a perk for your families as well, because obviously once your kids have access, your families have access to it too. That also includes the fitness log as well with the reflection questions. We also have a Facebook group, and it's a little PE community group that you guys can be a part of, ask questions and things like that. Can they be used in Google Classrooms? Yes, they can be used in Google Classroom. We do have a monthly subscription if you'd like to do that. That is available too. It's $19 a month, but with the promo code Janelle10, it's $17 a month. We do have a free trial going on right now, and that's a 7-day free trial when you guys sign up. So that, if you haven't started school yet, that is a perfect way for you guys to start writing down what you want to do and how you want to shape your curriculum. Yes, $19 a month. All right, if you guys have any more, or how long does the promo code last? So the students can log in at home anytime and any teacher can use it in their classroom. Yeah, so the students can log in at home at any time of the day, anytime they wanna do the workout, 24 hours every day. And can the teachers use it in their classroom? Yes, you guys can absolutely use it in your classrooms, absolutely. And how long does the promo code last? We are in October. It's going to go through October. But individually. No. So the $200 for the active schools, it's not individual. It's not per kid. It's per school. And Janelle10 is the promo code, and that would be $180 for the year. I'm gonna stay on for a couple more minutes, so if anybody else has questions, but if not, I want to thank you guys for hanging out with me on a Friday. I know it's been a crazy couple weeks and we're winding down, but I want to thank you guys for coming on. If you have any questions, please reach out to me. I'm gonna put my email down below so you can send me an email if you think about something later. Please send me an email. I'm looking forward to having you guys on board. It's a great program to have, especially in your school, for all your little kiddies. Can more than one teacher use in different classrooms at the same time? Yes, absolutely. The curriculum will be done soft copy as for the standards. What do you mean? Yes, you guys can align them to your certain standards. But they do match the national PE standards. If anybody else has any questions, I will definitely stay on just to answer your questions. You're welcome, Lynn. Thanks for coming. Oh, do I have a curriculum map? No, I don't have a curriculum map. Usually the teachers like to design their own curriculum map. I really just give you that fitness log to guide you along the way. Sure, Iman. You're welcome, absolutely. Thanks guys for coming, we appreciate it. I hope everyone has a safe and healthy year. Stay safe, stay healthy. You're welcome, Mary, thanks for coming. Thanks, Melissa. Yeah, so the classes, yes, exactly, that's a great question. The classes will be, they're arranged, or they're arranged from beginner, and then it moves up with them. So with all the classes, there's a progression and you start at class one and then you move along with them. So there's a progression from beginner to difficult. And it caters to kindergarten, well, pre-K to all the way up to 12th grade. Hi, another New Yorker. Hi, Amy. You're welcome. Bye, Iman. See ya, Mary. See ya, Wendell. Bye, Melissa. Bye, Iman. One more question. Okay, we got ya. Is there any classes for skills for soccer? You know what? That is a great question. like soccer and basketball. So we do different sports circuits. So within the sports circuit, volleyball, that's my sport. So within the sports circuit, there are different videos that display different movements in those sports. So not actually with the ball, but it goes over basketball, volleyball, swimming, football, all of baseball we even do. We do all of that within our sports circuits, but we do have those. And we're going to start bringing very, very soon some individual classes like soccer and basketball and volleyball that you can do at home by yourself with one ball, but not yet. No, the sports circuits they're already in there. You're welcome. So the actual classes with the balls, we don't have them yet, but soon. That's a work in progress. So maybe in the next few months. Thanks, Iman. Do you have another question? What about SCL? What's that? Yeah, so we are adding a wellness nutrition and wellness program too. And that's actually coming a lot sooner than the soccer and the volleyball and the basketball. That will be in the next couple weeks. All right. Thanks so much, Iman.